Hey, I wanted to update you guys on my current class and how's it going and anything I've learned in the last couple of weeks in my psych pharmacology course. If you are new here, welcome. If you're returning, thank you for coming back. My name is Dee Dee. Welcome to Healthy Hearing Loss. The first thing I wanted to talk about is an app that I downloaded on my phone, and it's called the Otter, I think it's Otter, Otter, O-T-T-E-R, .ai. That's the actual name on the app that you would use to search, and you go into the app program on your iPhone or in your Android through the Google game, whatever you guys do. Remember, I only have Apple products, so I don't know what Android do. But anyway, I downloaded the program and I wanted to kind of show you how it went. And here I am taking one of my courses last week and I'm using the transcription here. Now it's taking the voice and putting it into text for me. And it's actually pretty good. It looks good. It's quick. It seems to capture the words pretty well. That was good. And about 30 minutes later, I get a notification like this. So upgrade to the Pro, of course. So the cost that it was then is $12.99 billed monthly and about $100 annually. So I decided to pop on to a different PowerPoint that I was taking in the course. And this PowerPoint didn't recognize on my Apple. Of course, Apple seems to be a problem when it comes to Windows products. I jumped on the PowerPoint hoping I could hear something and there was no audio whatsoever. So this new transcription app is not going to work because there's no audio. That little thing doesn't work. So I'm a little disappointed. So getting back to the textbook, and I opened the book to kind of look at the very detailed, in-depth information on the topics that were being discussed this week. And it took me a little bit of time. That's what happened. And that's okay. I'm okay with that. You know, the fact is there'll be other audio files that I can use that I will use Oda with. I don't know if I'm going to pay for it yet. I don't think I can go any further until I do, but I haven't decided after that little mishap there. I'll give it some time. I'll think about it. One thing I do want to talk about is academic writing. Really important to have less stress in school by getting a little help, and I use Grammarly. I am not being sponsored by them. I'm not being paid by them. I have no affiliation with them. Nada, 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 nada. It's just me suggesting to you to do Grammarly. There is, you know, a trial that's free, and then there is a cost to it, really not that much. I can't remember how much it is because it was years ago, but you can go ahead and research that yourself to see if you have the financial means to support that. But I will say that with Grammarly, it is super helpful. You can open up a document and request that it does it academically. If you find an area that, like, oh, I don't know if that's worded right, it will help you, give you suggestions, and you can just reread it and see if it's something that you like. But I love Grammarly, and that will really reduce a lot of stress, especially if you have to do APA formatted papers. Very strict rules when it comes to APA, when it comes to references and inciting the references and the grammar and the structure, all that kind of stuff. So you want help with that. You can also go through your college. They have a library or a learning center. They usually have somebody there that will help you. So you can always contact them as well. I don't have the time to go to the school and meet with them, so I'd rather just use Grammarly. If you're going back to school for any level, associate's, bachelor's, master's, whatever you're doing, it doesn't matter. Use Grammarly. I think they even use it in high school. I don't know. In my last video, I told you I was going to go meet with my audiologist, which I did, and I told you that I wanted to see if I could get my Roger Select working. It's essentially a microphone or six microphones. You can see all those lines on the side. Those are each microphone that you can put on a table, and it will pick up six voices around you. So it's good for small classroom gatherings or for small meetings, that type of thing. I'm still waiting for the adapter for this. She has not called me, so I don't know why. fine. It's been 2 weeks. But anyway, in the meantime, she had given me the partner mic made by Phonak. This is what it looks like. And you can tell that it has the microphones in the bottom here, those little lines there. Those are all microphones. And this is used for one-on-one conversations. We use this with my preceptor, my faculty member, or my patient. I put it right on my badge, right on the clippy thing like that, as I have it around my neck. So when I need it, I can just pop it off. I did use it a couple times last week with patients who had very low voices, very deep low voices, and they mumble. At least I think they mumble. But they had the mask on. The mask on was very tight for some reason. I asked the patient if it's okay if I could clip this on their shirt. The one thing I noticed is that the way that the clip is mounted, the microphones are down in the bottom. So when they put it on the shirt, the microphones are further away. I don't know if that makes a difference. I would have preferred it to be upside down so the microphone is closer to the mouth. I heard great with it. I wouldn't say it was 100% better. It just basically pumps up the hearing so that I could hear the patient easier. It was clear. There was no distraction. The one thing I really liked about it is as soon as I turned it on, automatically connected to my hearing aids. I didn't have to do any pairing or fiddling around. It's really super, super good. If you're looking for a microphone, I would suggest looking for a one-on-one microphone that you can get from your audiologist that worked with your hearing aids. I'm hoping that when this thing comes back, I can get it to work. I'm almost done with my psych pharmacology. I have one more week left after my final this week, and then I start the program, the psychiatric nurse practitioner program, next month, September, on the 11th or so, and I'm actually going to the campus, and I would like to be able to use this if necessary. If I use it next month, then I'll pop back on here and let you know how it goes. Otherwise, I'll continue to use this one. I want to point out that I did use this with a couple of male voices, and they're very low frequency, and I generally have problems with low frequency with my hearing loss. I did not use it on children or females. I usually don't have a problem with female voices unless they have a really deep voice, but children I do. I have a problem, but we don't see a lot of children in my clinic right now, but I may use it when my nieces come over and I can ask them to put it on their shirt and see if that helps with me hearing them when they're running around, you know. I'm going to try it in a different environment and I'll let you know how it goes. If anybody has any suggestions for microphones that you'd like, I do have a Roger Penn somewhere, but I do not use it because it's super old and I don't know. It's just not something I use anymore. I don't know. I'm using these right now. Well, not this one, but this one I am. I'll update you as I go. That's all I wanted to say for this video. I will see you guys in the next one. Make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification so you know about the next video. If you're interested in this series of me going back to school, I will be doing other reviews on assistive listening devices like the microphones and anything else I can come up with. If you want to learn about those, go ahead and hit the subscribe and bell notification as well. Also like this video if you thought it was good. Thanks for stopping by. Take care. Bye.